Welcome to the channel Mathematics Students Helper. Please like this channel, share it with your friends, subscribe. Please subscribe this channel and request your friends to subscribe this. Now I discuss about mapping. I share 5 videos. This is the part 1. Please see another videos. The link of that videos are in describe box. At first, I give the definition of mapping. What is mapping? Let A and B be two non-empty sets. A mapping F from A to B is a rule that assigns to each element X of A to a different element Y in B. Here I draw two non-empty sets A and B, and F is a rule that assigns to each element of A, that is, there are some elements in A, we have to assign that elements to a definite element in Y. If this is possible, then we write in that form F such that A to B. Now I discuss the term each element. Each element of A, this means that every element of A have to participate in that assignment. Now we will see how the elements in A are assigned to a definite element in B. See that here every element in A are assigned to a definite element of B. That is, there are no elements in A which has more than one assignment. But you can see that this element has an assignment, and this is also assignment of that element. But for this element, this assignment is unique. That is, this element has no assignment. Therefore, assignment of that element is unique. Now I discuss the term definite element Y in B. In mapping, this is not possible. As you can see that X has two assignments, Y1 and Y2. This violates the definition of the mapping, mainly the term definite element Y in B. Therefore, this is not a mapping. Now I give two figures. In first figure, it is mapping. Second figure, this is not a mapping because X is connected more than one element. Here Y1, Y2, that is, this is X, this is connected to two elements Y1 and Y2. This is not possible. This violates the term definite element Y in B. Now I give some another definition related to mapping. At first, there are two sets A and B, both are non-empty. The first set, that is A is called domain of F, and B is called codomain of F. This is codomain and this is domain. Here I draw two non-empty sets A and B, and F is a rule that assigns to each element of A, that is, there are some elements in A, we have to assign that elements to a definite element in Y. The mapping is also written as Y equal to Fx form, where X is the free image, Y is the image. Here X is arbitrary element and Y is the image of X. Therefore, this mapping can be written as y equal to fx. This mapping can also be written as in that form. F is the collection of pair elements, pairwise elements. First component belong to A and second component belong to B. Our second component y equal to f of x, that is second component is equal to f of x. Y is the image of x and x is the preimage of y. Therefore, the component this pair has two component. First component is the image of component is the preimage of second component. Second component is the image of first component under the mapping F. Here I write down the mapping in that form, which is discussed in that form. Clearly, you can see that F is a subset of A cross B. F is a subset of A cross B. Now, our question is here. The question is mapping a relation? The answer will be yes. Every mapping is a relation, because we know a relation is a subset of A cross B. The video related relation is discussed in the previous video, whose link is given in the description box. You can see that video for concept. Now our question is the converse true? That is, every relation is mapping. Is this true? No, every relation is not necessarily mapping. Now I will give some example to justify above lines. Here I give two sets which are both non-empty, A and B. A contains three elements, A, B and C. B contains four elements, 1, 2, 3 and 4. First example is that F1 is the collection of pairwise elements A1, B4, C2. Now the question is F1 a mapping? What will be answer? Answer will be yes, because here every element of A participate in that relation. You can see that A, B, C are all present in that relation, and images of A, B, C are unique. That is, image of A is 1, image of B is 4, image of C is 2. Therefore, this is a mapping. Now I give another example. Clearly, F2 is a relation, because F2 is a subset of A cross B. Now our question is this a mapping? What will be answer? No, answer will be no. Why? Now I see the definition. Here we see that each element x, here we see that to each element x, we have to assign to each element x of A. Therefore, every element of A have to participate in that relation. But here C does not participate in that relation. Therefore, this is not a mapping. Now I will give another example. Clearly, F2 is a relation. Now our question is F2 a mapping? The answer is, the answer will be no. Why? Let's go. We have to see the definition of mapping. Here we highlight the term a definite element y in B. That is, every element of X will have to only one image. But here A has two images. One is 1 and another is 3. Therefore, this is not a mapping. There is another relation F4. Now our question is this a mapping? The answer will be yes. Here you can see that A and B has one element, one image, which is here 1. but this does not violate the definition of mapping, because in the definition of mapping it is given that every element of A have to participate in that relation. Here ABC participate in that relation, and every element A or B or C will have to only one image. Here A has one image, B has only one image, and C has only one image. Therefore this does not violate the definition of mapping. This mapping, the last mapping example 4, this is called many to one, because there are many elements, that is more than one element. A and B has only one element, therefore many to one. Now I will give some another examples of mapping. At first, if x defined by f of x equal to 5, this is called constant mapping, because the whatever the input, here inputs are 1, 0.5, 7.256, root 2, every element 1 or minus 0.5, root 2 or 7.256 has image 5. Therefore this mapping is called constant mapping. This is another example of mapping f x equal to x. Here you can see that input and output, that is pre-image and image, are equal. This mapping is called identity mapping. One has image 1, 0. The image and pre-image are equal. This mapping is called identity mapping. This is important mapping. It has very application, which are discussed in next videos. You can see this. There are another examples, f x equal to x square. This mapping is not injective. This mapping is injective. These are not surjective, not bijective. I will discuss later about injective mapping, bijective mapping, surjective mapping. These are discussed in video part 2 video. You can see that the link of the video are given in the description box. Please see the next videos. I hope that all of you can understand this video. If you understand this video, then please like, share it with your friends, and also subscribe, and request your friends to subscribe this video. Thank you very much. Please see the next videos.